Like many of us, you have been under attack by allergies, and we wanted to know how long is this going to last and if we can expect it to get worse. Meteorologist Eric Zarnix went out and got some answers.
The doctor's office isn't the most desirable place to be, but because of this year's allergy season, more and more people are finding themselves right here, and it's not just because of the lollipops.
Allergies.
Okay, open your mouth and say, huh?
If you're lucky enough not to have them, you more than likely know someone who does. And this fall, for those folks, it's been worse than most.
We are seeing people who have never had symptoms before who are having new symptoms this year because between the combination of high ragweed, high mold, and poorer air quality, they're finally developing symptoms.
The culprit? Mold. While many troublesome molds are associated with too much rain, others thrive on too little.
And so right now we're seeing a lot of the dry molds in the atmosphere, and those tend to get washed out of the atmosphere when you get a good rain through.
Between September and October, we have only seen 16% of our normal rainfall, allowing the dry mold count to explode. With this different kind of allergen in the air and no rain to wash it out, new people are discovering they have allergies. If you can wait it out, the first frost should bring those numbers back down to earth. However, if you can't, here are some options.
The standard therapies of the nose sprays and the pills are incredibly effective for most people, as well as allergy shots. Those can reduce symptoms by upwards of 80 to 90% in people.
So this fall, as you start raking up those leaves, one recommendation is to pick up this Sanders mask. You can get it at any local store, and it will reduce the amount of allergens that you inhale. Reporting, Eric Zarnitz, News 5.